Well, I'm glad you could all join, and you especially could all join for what I believe is a truly momentous occasion. I'm sending up my budget for fiscal year 1987, which I think makes some common sense reductions in federal spending, and it reduces the deficit by $38 billion to meet the requirements of Graham Rudnam Hollings. As you know, that passed Congress overwhelmingly last year. And it does so without reducing our commitment to the poor and the elderly, and it does so without weakening our national security. And it does so without increasing taxes to pay for more spending. So I am pleased to sign these copies of the budget for all of you and the management report which accompanies it. And I hope we can work together on this important step toward a balanced budget. And I'm not going to try to sort these out protocol-wise. I'm just going to hope I can get them signed straight. Strong.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. We have a couple of others who are not here, but I think are lost in traffic somewhere.
Right, Jim Wright says he's lost in traffic.
Did you invite Chip?
In view of your nice remarks about the speaker, I'll be happy to convey one to him too, Mr. President. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, President.
Well, that's the best speech been made in the 32 years I've been in the Senate.
Thank you very much.
What you said about Mr. O'Neill was very, very gracious.
It was a nice touch because I think it gets us off started on the right foot, hopefully, to get the cooperation between the legislative and executive branch and between the two parties. The only way we're going to get the job done.
Thank you.
Okay.
Mr. President, sir, is it going to take an oil import fee to make this tax reform plan balance out properly?
I don't know. I said that this is one thing that I'm willing to look at. The whole idea, however, is that you know that the end result must be revenue neutral, that it does not increase the amount of money we're taking from the private sector for government in that tax reform. And this means that the discussion is going to be what are the things, the tax privileges and so forth with regard to deductions that can be taken out to simplify it and yet still maintain the same level of revenue. So I've said that I'm willing to look at that on that basis.
How do you think you'll do trying to sell that increase in the defense budget to a Congress that's worried about reducing the deficit?
Well, I'm most hopeful that that we can, because I think we're living in a very dangerous world, and we're still playing catch-up. We are still far behind in both conventional and strategic weapons by the Soviet Union.
Fred.
All right. Thank you all. thank you for your you know, one of the items of business this year is making the federal government financially fit. So today we embark on a road and historic opportunity that I think is provided by Grand Hudson House. I just given Doyle and Bob Michael and Strom Thurmond our fiscal 1987 budget. As I told them and the Democrat leaders, this is an historic budget. It cuts spending as required by Graham Rudd and Hollings and sets us on a path to a balanced budget. We've all heard some voices say it is not possible to reduce the deficit unless we raise taxes or cut defense or cut into programs for our poor and elderly. My answer is that this budget reduces the deficit by $38 billion without having any of those bad effects. So it can be done. And I think on our part up here, we've done it with what we have sent to you. We're going to work closely with you in both the House and the Senate, and I'm counting on Bob Dole and Bob Michael to work together so that we have a united Republican approach on the budget. And I'm going to ask Jim Miller to explain in greater detail what the budget contains.
Thank you, Mr. President. Before you are two volumes.
Well, welcome. Pleased to see you.
Very glad to see you.
Yeah. Pleased to have you.
Thank you very much for the time to spend.
Nice to see you.
How do you do, sir?
Thank you very much.
She became Bob and Nancy and myself very close friends. So I kept after her to teach me at least some single expression that I could use in her language, if I could say this. And it finally came down to most that she offered to me I couldn't master. And I finally could say Haben Sie ein Streichholz. And one night in a restaurant, and Nancy at that time, my wife, smoked a little bit. And so she took out a cigarette and there were no matches on the table. And when the waitress came, I just, kidding me, thinking I was kidding Nancy, I said, Haben Sie ein Streichholz? And I got such a flood of German back that she happened to be German. She thought I talked her language. She looked at me rather strangely when I told her the only thing I could say was picture.
I'm great. How are you?
Just fine.
I said that you would look like the youngest man on the platform.
Let me hold on to those so they don't get that. There we go.
Thank you. All right.
Good to see you.
Well, good to see you.
about your parades. I didn't expect to see you twice today.
I said, well, God, we're done.
Of course. You're wonderful, too. You did.
Thank you.
It was a very fine speech.
Thank you.
You can't match the boss, though.
Well, he's the master.
Yes.
He's the master.
No. There was nothing.
Nothing. They're still shooting. Fine. You know, I'm not making very fast progress, but fundamental progress.
Good.
There's a piece in the Times today. I was going to bring him, but he picked up an elephant about Irving Brown. You know. It's in the LA Times.
Yeah.
Some of the lefties or friends are complaining about the work that he's doing over there. But I was up in my side. Making good progress in that area. And I was going to suggest that, if we look it out, I think there's another good long trip.
I love it. It's great.
Isn't that great?
That's great.
Wasn't it?
How do you do it though?
Well, you release that. Go ahead.
Yeah?
If you release it here.
Yeah.
And then just pet.
Mm-hmm.
And like try to hit it over by my mm-hmm. foot, then you just reel it back in.
I love sports photography. That is the most ridiculous thing I've ever.
Oh, it's fun.
Oh, it's great.
What
I mean,
do
it's
when Don comes in the morning at 9 o'clock. You gotta be here for the night.
Did somebody give the credit just to the credit?
Yeah.
7 o'clock.
Are you working?
Huh?
Mr. President.
Hi.
I suppose the chief told you that.
He hinted at it.
Yeah. Well, a fellow named Stu Spencer has been talking with me, and I think I'm going to take him up on his offer to do a little work. And I think that fellow's someone that you've got a little history with.
Yes, yes. That doesn't make it sound as if you're going to be far away.
I'm not going to be very...
Well, so I don't know. Well, I just want to thank you for all that you've done.
Well, it's been an honor and a pleasure, certainly a privilege. Done some good.
Yes.
Made a lot of progress.
Now this guy, Mr. President, spent a lot of hours late at night into the early morning. He was one of those ones that had to babysit the Senate or the House when they were going through some of these votes. And it was tedious work.
Yes.
He knows I'm the one that has my initials on all those phone calls. Well, I'm optimistic. I think you're right when you say this is a year of opportunity. Be around and be very helpful. And, I think Don's got things.
Yeah. All
right. He's a good man.
This is his successor.
Hello. Hi. Good to see you. Why don't you turn around here and get a picture taken with the person?
He's coming over from his affairs up on the hill.
The last year. That's been quite a challenge.
It would still be a foreign country of a Congress.
Yes. Well, it'll be a challenging year. Sure will. We'll try to do a good job for
you. Well, thank you very much.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for the opportunity.
All right. Hope you won't remember Hades.
All right.
Now, he signed on for the duration now. I told him.
I'll be around.
He's going to have to stay for the duration.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
President.
Hi, Evan, how are you?
Happy 57th birthday. It's a typo, you know.
Yes, I can see. I like it. Well, listen, why don't you come over here and
okay.
Sit down and go. And I know that you've already helped author this first edition of this.
Oh, did you get
and
that?
And you don't really look that old either. Taft and Roosevelt, The Intimate Letters of Archie. And so forth. Yes, I've got it.
I enjoyed it.
I couldn't understand. It took me quite a while to understand its frame-up.
They did a beautiful job.
They sure did.
And in less than 24 hours.
I was thinking, wait a minute, I know this has got to be something. How is it here in this book?
It happened to be a coincidence. He was heading for Illinois the day you were born. So we just took advantage of that.
Well, I think it was only a spur line that went to... by Tampico, Illinois. I don't think it was
right.
A main line.
Mr. President, I've been doing things like that. The day you were born, it's rather funny, they announced a new breed of turkey in Illinois.
It was one of the worst days of the winter. It was snowing in north and south of the state. Raw, sharp, ugly winds, dangerously slippery streets.
Yes, hi.
Happy birthday, Mr. President.
Nicholas wanted to say happy birthday.
Hello there.
Had a little
hi.
Say hi.
I'm going to tell you, they never can see anything but the cameras.
There you go, Nicholas. Look up there. And Nick,
hey, Nick, Nick.
Hey.
Nick.
What's up?
Nicholas, there you go.
There you go.
Yeah. Well, we're kind of a long time getting around saying goodbye here.
Well, that's all right. Any time. We brought you a little headband for you to wear when you work out.
Ah, well. Anyone take me for McMahon?
I don't know.
Maybe.
All right. That's well, great. Listen, wait, wait.
My goodness. She shouldn't be giving us presents.
For you, just a bookmark. And that's to keep the papers blown away in your desk.
Thank you.
Now, this is for this young man, but he may have to wait a little bit to grow up to this.
Oh,
that's terrific.
He's going to love it.
He's only got two teeth, so he'll have to wait.
Yes, yeah. But he'll certainly remember that.
I don't think you can hold it. I think
I'm going to give it to Daddy. Thank you very much,
Mr.
President.
Thank you very much.
Great pleasure.
Happy birthday.
Yes.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
President, you remember Susie Trees?
Yes,
hello there. How are you, Mr. President?
Hi,
brother,
how are you?
Sister.
Well, it's good to see you.
Happy birthday.
Well, thank you. Hello there.
Hello, Mr. President. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Well, nice to see you. And what are you doing now that you're not taking care of us?
Well, I'm probably going to be going on your trip in the spring.
Well.
Coming back every now and then. Keep people honest, you know what I mean?
Well, just in case.
Yes.
I mean, because you're here, we don't want you to forget us.
Oh.
It was just a little souvenir.
Thank you.
Throw it at somebody or something. These are key rings, and maybe these souvenirs.
Oh, that's very nice. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Happy birthday. Many
thank
more.
You.
We had a present for you that we left in the car.
Oh, well,
it was a Chicago Bears t-shirt. We brought that from Illinois.
We
might have gotten one of those before.
Super Bowl t-shirt.
Super Bowl. Well, I'm from Illinois, too.
I know. Right. I know.
In fact, it was quite a personal friend of Papa Bear.
Papa
Harris.
Bear Dallas,
yeah.
Oh, really?
Yes. Met him through Nancy's father.
We had lunch next to George Allen today, as a matter of fact.
Oh, well, he's a good friend, too.
Maybe we can get the Cubs in there in a couple years.
Yeah.
Yeah,
back
maybe.
Back when I was broadcasting them.
They used to
do their games, and yes, they were way up there at the top every
they
year.
They were good in
in the World Series a couple of times while I was broadcasting.
Well. Maybe we can all do an event there in Chicago sometime. Okay, thank you very much.
Yes, thank
happy
you.
Birthday.
We certainly enjoyed listening to you at the prayer breakfast
this
morning,
prayer
too.
Prayer breakfast this morning.
Oh, very nice.
Thank you very much.
Well, nice to meet you, sir.
Bye. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Mr. President, remember
excuse
Stephanie Ebert?
Yes,
happy
hi.
Birthday.
How are you?
Just fine, thanks.
Well, thank you.
It's my birthday,
hi,
David.
How are you?
It's
nice to see you.
It's been an honor and the most exciting time of my life to work
well,
for you.
Well, listen, I thank you for everything, but I also wish you well and where you're
well,
going.
Well, thank you. I'm excited.
Please give Bill my best regards.
I'll do it.
Again.
I'll do it. Thank you
here's
so much.
Something so you won't forget
oh,
us.
Oh, my gosh. That's all for you. You're the one who gets to get the presents today.
And, this is a little souvenir.
That's very nice. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Happy birthday.
Thank you for everything.
All
great
right.
Man.
Good to see you.
Thanks,
Jim.
Take care of everybody in Texas.
I'll do it. Take care.
Yes.
Thank you.
Right.
President, happy birthday.
This is a greeting from the director. You can look at that. These are from the men and women of the Presidential Protective Division. Happy birthday.
Hey, they shouldn't do this. No way I ever can respond adequately.
Oh, no need to do that. We'd like to see you open this one just to see the response on your face.
You gotta be careful.
Finally,
they didn't check it.
We finally. It's not that. We finally think we found something that you don't have.
The what?
That you don't have. I hope they didn't take it long.
Hey. Oh, my goodness, Ray. Hey, this is wonderful.
One for each stall.
Well, my goodness, thank you very much.
My pleasure.
I'll put these back in the box and you know where these are going.
Oh, I bet.
Oh, that's great.
I know you can figure that out, but these brass plates are separate. And on the back, the screws actually go through the brass plates, through the wood, and then into the stall.
Okay, listen, thank you. And just in time, too, because we haven't got enough stalls, and I've got to go out there and plan some way that we can add another stall or two. Oh, that's wonderful. Thank you very much. You know where those go?
Yes, sir. We have less than a few days.
Yep. You knew that when you were on our way out there about another week, didn't you?
Yeah, that's Wednesday. Yeah. A week from yesterday.
Yeah.
We'll let you open that last one, man. I think you guys get the prize for the best gift.
That's it.
Oh, that's... Hey, you mean I'm an agent now? Hey, look at that. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thanks. Well, thank you. Oh, that's great. I should not have done it. Thank you all very much. I shall deliver a thank you for all the rest of the fellows there.
Okay.